First is always what the patient is able to tolerate. As patient gets exposed to any of these drugs, there's potential toxicities that can develop. So we always look at patient factors when we're choosing what the next best regimen for somebody would be. We look at their disease. We look to see how much benefit they received from prior therapy. And if they received a very long-term benefit from a very specific class of medications, then it's possible that they'll receive a similar benefit if we change them to a different medication in the same class. So those are some patient factors and disease factors we look at. We look at their cytogenetic risk to see if they have developed some new or acquired some new high-risk mutations. We tend to reach for our most effective and potent therapy with the hopes of offsetting that as much as we can. At this point, we haven't quite gotten to where we can use that data to specifically target any of those mutations. Venetoclax is a medication that does have very significant activity in 11-14 translocated patients, but at this point, you know, there's some safety concerns with that that are hopefully going to be teased through, but that is one example of targeted drug that's going to hopefully be available for patients in the future that carry that particular mutation. And hopefully more will be discovered and more to come in that particular space.